Hi guys, today we have a Killian's video. At the moment, Killian is one of my favorite fragrance houses, mainly because I liked so many fragrances from the house. I did quite a bit of reviews on Killian's fragrances separately, but I thought it would be a good idea to do just one video on my favorite fragrances from Killian. Today I have 9 fragrances that I absolutely adore. I wear all of them. I'm gonna start with the fragrances that I like tiny bit less, and we're gonna move on to the top, to the fragrances that I absolutely love. So I'm gonna start with the fragrance that I smelled recently. It's called Roses on Ice. If you watch my channel, maybe you already know that I've never been a fan of rose fragrances. And very rarely I like rose fragrance. But if we leave aside my personal preferences, just from the fragrance points of view, I think it's an incredible fragrance. It's very tender, powdery, nice, pleasant rose. Every time I spray this fragrance on myself, I just wait for the dry down because that is my favorite part of the fragrance. So if you don't want a rose fragrance to be super dark or mysterious or dramatic or anything like this, you just want a tender, pleasant, gorgeous smelling rose, check Roses on Ice. The second fragrance is going to be Moonlight in Heaven. I must say that this is one of the most special Killian fragrances for me. I did a separate review on that fragrance and I was giving my associations, and I was mentioning like beach, waves, tropics, dinner, like some tropical fruits, because it's quite a fruity fragrance. Again, very rarely I like fruity fragrances, they're not really my thing, but I really like Moonlight in Heaven. It's very deep, has vetiver, jasmine, mango. It's very sweet, very smooth, and as I said, I keep it for more like special occasions or where I'm in the mood. I think Moonlight in Heaven is very pleasant, gorgeous smelling fragrance for more of a special occasions. If you like fruity fragrances, that's definitely the one from Killian to check out. The next fragrance is Back to Black, absolutely iconic fragrance. I love it. It's a little bit smoky, it has tobacco notes, a little bit tiny bit of cherry, a bit of honey. Overall, it's a very deep, special, incredible fragrance. I really like Back to Black, but I was already mentioning in some of my previous videos that I don't really like the dry down of the fragrance. So the opening, the heart is really nice for me, but the dry down, there is some notes in there that I don't like. That's why it's not on the top of the list. It's closer to the end. So this was Back to Black. So the next fragrance that I absolutely love is a Black Phantom, and I still remember the day I sprayed it on myself for the first time. I fell in love with it straight away. That kind of fragrance impossible not to like for me. It has a little bit of a rum notes, coffee notes. It's very deep, very special, absolutely intoxicating, 100% gourmand for me. If you like Back to Black, I'm almost certain you're gonna love Black Phantom. For me, a Back to Black, Black Phantom, Straight to Heaven and Intoxicated, they are kind of going in the same direction. So if you like one of those fragrances, most likely you will like the rest. If you like gourmand, boozy, deep, unique fragrances, definitely check Black Phantom. The next fragrance is Rolling in Love. Absolutely love from the first sight. I remember smelling this fragrance for the first time. It's very tender, smooth, a little bit milky, closer to the skin. Absolutely gorgeous white scent. It's a little bit musky. It has a little almond notes. Absolutely love wearing this fragrance. And if I didn't like Good Girl Gone Bad so much that I do, probably Rolling in Love would be my favorite fragrance to wear, and probably will be my signature. Very pleasant, smooth, tender, gorgeous white floral scent. And if you like Good Girl Gone Bad, probably, I'm almost sure that you will like Rolling in Love. Next fragrance is Angel Shares. That was no way I wouldn't like this fragrance, because it's very sweet, it's gourmand, it has an amazing combination of the cognac and hazelnut notes. Very boozy, it's very sweet. Actually, this fragrance is quite a long lasting, and on a dry down, it's absolutely delicious, sweet sandalwood. Normally, I don't really like sandalwood in fragrances at all, but in this fragrance, it's so sweet, so smooth, that dry down I really like. If you like sweet, gourmand, boozy fragrances, definitely check Angel Share. And finally, guys, top three favorite fragrances from Kilian for me. On the third place, I would put Straight to Heaven. I think this is an incredible fragrance for men, but I do love to wear it. It's very intoxicating. It's rum, it's woody, it's sweet. I did a separate review on Straight to Heaven, and actually I did a separate review to the majority of fragrances I mentioned today. So I'm gonna link them down below. If you're interested in more detailed description of those fragrances, just go and check my other videos. So if you like Black Phantom and Back to Black, I'm almost certain you're gonna love Straight to Heaven. I think it's one of the best sellers from Kilian, and I can see why. It's incredible, delicious, boozy, sweet, fantastic fragrance. In second place, I put Intoxicated, only for one reason, because on the first place I have my signature scent. Otherwise, Intoxicated is just a masterpiece, in my opinion, from Kilian. It's incredibly deep, complex, unique, and intoxicating fragrance. Honestly, this is just the right name for this scent. Absolutely 100% intoxicating. I love to wear it, absolutely. I think this will make an incredible signature scent for men. And if as a girl, I adore this scent so much. The only one little problem that I have with this fragrance, I wish it would last longer. Unfortunately, on my skin, it doesn't really last. But as a scent itself, oh my God, this is 100% a masterpiece. So this is Intoxicated. So I could probably say that the first place was divided. My favorite fragrance from Kilian. And as I said, mainly because this is my signature scent, I wear it every day, I love it, and I can't imagine my life currently without this fragrance, is Good Girl Gone Bad. Very tender, smooth, incredible white floral fragrance. And this is very special fragrance for me because it made me love tuberose and white floral fragrances. I never used to, but when I smelled this one, oh my God, I fell in love straight away. Very creamy, very smooth, intoxicating, just a fantastic scent. I did smell Good Girl Gone Bad Extreme. And for the reason I already mentioned in the beginning of the video, because I'm not really big fan of rose fragrances, I didn't really like the extreme version because they added rose into it. If you like roses, go for Good Girl Gone Bad Extreme. And if you are like me, go for the original Good Girl Gone Bad. Thanks for watching. And if you enjoy watching my videos and you want to see more, subscribe to my channel and see you soon.